Guys, so I don't know if you remember, but just a couple videos ago in my April earnings video, I discussed two goals that I had for the month of May. Now, I am here to tell you, whether you remember or you don't, that on the second day of May, I had already crushed one of those goals. Now, stay tuned to this video to find out more about that, but I want to start off this video letting you know how important it is to set goals for yourself and your Amazon influencer program and any other thing that you're working on. Setting goals is so important because it gives you something to look forward to, it gives you something to strive for, and it gives you something to work hard and push to achieve. Now, like I said, it was just the second day of May that I crushed one out of my two goals and I was so happy. So in this video, I will discuss that goal with you, as well as show you my first week of May earnings and talk to you about the Amazon Influencer Program. So what's up, everybody? My name is Mercedes Gomez, and we are so close to 1,000 subscribers, if we're not already. But I don't think we will be just yet. So if you don't know, I am giving away a $100 gift card as soon as we hit 1,000 subscribers. I haven't figured out what the rules are going to be and how we're going to achieve it and if we're going to go live, what we're going to do, but I think, you know, it's time. I've been teasing a live for so many weeks now, and for whatever reason, it just hasn't happened. But I'm ready to give some stuff away. I'm ready to give away this gift card, and I'm really ready to just celebrate with you guys on such a huge accomplishment in such a short period of time. Now, that's all, you know, coming up in the future, but this video, like I said, is going to be about my first week in May and how you can compare your results to mine, and we can just talk about some changes that we've seen in the program and how it's been affecting our earnings. So without a further ado, let's jump right in. Real quick, here is a picture of kind of the graph, what I saw the first week of May, you know, about how much I was making, as well as my clicks. You could see my commission to clicks. I'll go into all the detail, but I just wanted to show you a real quick screenshot of what my graph is currently looking like. Now, on May 1st, which was a Monday, I had a total of 1,667 clicks and made a total commissions amount of $180.44. This was the first day of May, this was a Monday, and you know, this is about the time where we were seeing those weird things happen with the Amazon Influencer Program, and like everyone's clicks and commissions just started to go up. So that's how I started off the month. Great way to start off the month. I am not complaining, but let me know if you saw this as well. Now, on May 2nd, this is the day that just blew my mind and got me really excited to continue posting these review videos and continue my Amazon influencer journey. Now, moving on, May 2nd was a Tuesday, and this was the day that just absolutely blew my mind. Now, on May 2nd, I had a total of 1,670 clicks and a grand commission amount of $200.04. That was crazy to me because in my previous video, like I mentioned in the intro, one of my goals for the month of May was to hit $200 in a day. And here I am the second week of May and I already had hit that. Absolutely mind-blowing. And if this doesn't show you that you need to set goals, then I don't know what will. But when you set goals, you achieve them. And that's what we do on this channel. So May 2nd, $200.04, what a huge win, a huge accomplishment. And honestly, when you think about it, I can't even believe we're making $200 in one single day. Moving on to May 3rd, which was a Wednesday, I had a total of 1,576 clicks and made a total commissions amount of $159.96. So not bad. May 4th, which was a Thursday, we had a total amount of clicks of 1,467 and made a total commissions amount of $160.72. Moving on to Friday, May 5th, we had a total of 1,467 clicks and made a total commissions amount of $155.45. So as you can see, the numbers are pretty consistent. They did drop after that $200 day, but I'm not complaining. Rounding out the week on Friday, May the 6th, we had a total amount of 1,569 clicks and made a total commissions of $187.39. Last but certainly not least was May 7th. This was a Saturday, and we had a total amount of 1,646 clicks for a total commissions of $163.56. So this is what the first week of May looked like for me, and getting my numbers up to about 150 to 200 is really gonna help me achieve my next goal, which is hitting $4,000 in commissions for the month of May. So if you tally all of that up, you will see that for the first 7 days in the month of May, I made a total amount of $1,207.56. In one single week, the very first week of May, I also achieved my $200 a day goal, and we are setting a really high bar for this month. So I'm really excited to keep going and see what my final numbers are for the month. Now, a couple other statistics that I had include a total of 11,092 clicks. I shipped a total amount of 1,670 items. I had 64 returned items. My conversion rate was 15.06%. And my shipped items revenue was $49,448. So, all in all, this got me $1,207.56 in commission. Now, all in all, I think this was a pretty great week, if not easily my best week of this program, and I'm so happy it came in the beginning of the month. One good thing is I can go back and look at, you know, other months or other weeks and see how this compares. And this is the best week I've had so far, and I'm so glad it's how I started off the month. Now, some things that I feel like contributed to this is whatever Amazon is doing behind the scenes that we don't really know. Now, some things that I've heard from people include the fact that Amazon is showing videos now on mobile devices for products that on the web don't have videos. So that is a huge thing. If that is true, I'm not really seeing it all that much, but if that is true, I could definitely see how that's increasing people's commissions and people's clicks. Now, for me, what's been just real weird is that I haven't noticed a change in my top products. I haven't noticed much change aside from my commission and my clicks slightly going up. Now, to me, I think I'm just selling a whole lot more of my top products. I think a lot of my videos have gone back to my top product pages, and I'm staying there, and I think that is really helping me get even more sales than I was before, and it's really bringing my commission amounts up. Now, I don't know how or why this is happening, but I do know for a couple weeks in April, videos were changing out a lot, and I was getting kicked off of product pages very quickly. But as of lately, or as of this month of May, I've noticed my videos have been pretty still on product pages, especially the ones that I'm doing good with, and I'm continuing to make commissions on these products every single day. Now, another thing that's just been really good about my channel, and I really contribute this to the fact that I review a lot of small products and I sell a wide variety of things, about 200 products a day, 200 different products a day. What really helps me with this is it helps my commissions stay very consistent. If I don't sell everything the same every single day, I may start selling some of my other products and everything kind of levels out. If I lose one sale, it doesn't hurt me. Or if I lose one product, it doesn't hurt me, because I'm selling so many different products that my commissions are very, very consistent. Now, that might not be the case for you if you're reviewing higher end or higher priced products, because losing one sale or losing one product will really hurt the amount of commission you make in a day. You're really going to see this if you have a lower amount of video reviews. The less video reviews you have, the more you'll kind of hurt from the impact of being kicked off of a product page or not making a sale for one of your high priced products. Now, all in all, I'm still just about at 740 video reviews, which I've been around this amount for a while now. I'm really not focusing on kicking out a ton of content or a ton of video reviews because my commissions have been staying fairly consistent without me uploading a ton a day. So as of right now, I've been spending more of my time on YouTube or, you know, some of my other streams of income because this one is running pretty self-efficient by itself. However, because I had set another goal of hitting $4,000 in commission for the month of May, I know I'm gonna have to turn it up a notch. I know I'm gonna have to kick out some more product review videos, and I know I'm gonna have to do something a little different than I did in April if I want to achieve that goal. Now, like I said earlier in this video, setting goals is so important, and I really encourage you to set goals for yourself and for your results in this program. If you want to be at a certain amount of videos by the end of the month, set that goal. If you want to make a set amount of commission, set that goal. If you want to just, you know, have 20 products to review by the end of the month, set that goal. Any kind of goal is good, but as long as you set those goals, then you're gonna have this expectation in your mind, or you're gonna have something to work and reach for. So I really encourage you guys to do that. So I hope that you guys kind of enjoyed this video. It's probably a little bit shorter than you're used to, but I really wanted to get on here and show you guys what my first week looked like for the month of May. Use this video to help set goals for yourself and your Amazon influencer program journey so that you can continue growing and continue achieving great success. Now, like I said in the beginning of this video, I'm probably almost to 1,000 subscribers at this point, or at 1,000 subscribers. So if you guys have been a part of my channel for a while now, this is huge, and I cannot wait to give away one of these $100 gift cards to one of you amazing people. So stay tuned because the rules will be out very soon. Hit the subscribe button, like, comment, and turn on post notifications, and just stay tuned. That's all I have to say. We are not going anywhere, and this channel is going to continue to grow, and we're all going to continue growing together. So you guys have a great rest of your day. I bet you're probably sick of seeing me already this week. This is my second video in a row, and so you guys have a great one, and I'll see you soon. Bye!